Welcome to EIS Services Orientation. The EIS contract for telecommunications and IT services offers a wide variety of services designed to meet your agency's needs now and for many years into the future. The following materials focus on many of the services available and offer you ideas on how to better understand what is relevant to your requirements. In this section, we provide an overview of some of the data services available under EIS and discuss the features and pricing structure associated with the services. Here we provide an overview of the Ethernet Transport Service available under EIS and discuss the features and pricing structure associated with this service. Ethernet is another of the data services available under EIS. Some claim that ETS is the future. Ethernet is a high-speed LAN-to-LAN transport protocol for networks. Ethernet was initially developed as a LAN standard for connecting over both copper and fiber media at high speeds. It has evolved to connect users across large distances, long haul. The Ethernet Transport Service under EIS supports both intra- and inter-agency connectivity. Some of the benefits of ETS is that it can efficiently support some future evolving technologies, such as software-defined networks, SDN, and network function virtualization, NFV. Software-defined networking, SDN, is an approach to computer networking that allows network administrators to programmatically initialize, control, change, and manage network behavior dynamically, as opposed to the traditional static architecture. Network Function Virtualization, NFV, is an initiative to virtualize the network services that are now being carried out by proprietary dedicated hardware. The goal of NFV is to decouple network functions from dedicated hardware devices and allow network services that are now being carried out by routers, firewalls, load balancers, and other dedicated hardware devices to be hosted on virtual machines or VMs. ETS can also be used to enable full end-to-end management capability, giving network administrators greater control and oversight of the network. Ethernet also effectively carries voice, data, and/or video. On the EIS contract, standard CLINs are offered with bandwidth speeds from 1 megabit per second up to 40 gigabits per second. ETS also provides bandwidth on demand, scalable and burstable bandwidth options, which is discussed in greater detail in the section on features. Ethernet can be either a shared or dedicated service. Shared Ethernet service means the traffic is multiplexed and carried over shared or common facilities and compete with one another for available bandwidth. The ETS ELAN service option is an example of a shared service. Dedicated bandwidth means that all users have a portion of bandwidth dedicated to them solely. The ETS E-line service option is an example of a dedicated point-to-point service with reserved bandwidth. Shared is the lower-cost service option, but dedicated is the more reliable because there is no competition for bandwidth resources. This diagram is an example of Ethernet transport service. ETS provides point-to-point, point-to-multipoint, and multipoint-to-multipoint connections. This diagram shows an Ethernet private ELAN multipoint service. In this diagram, the three agency sites are connected via Ethernet transport over a backbone network. Per the EIS contract, carrier-grade Ethernet transport service for agencies will be implemented over an MPLS backbone. Each site requires its own access arrangement, and each location can have a different port bandwidth. The access arrangement for each site is not included in the ETS pricing. Each required access arrangement is handled and priced separately and should be able to support the bandwidth capacity of the associated Ethernet port. For example, as shown in the diagram, 100 megabits per second at the remote sites above and 1 gigabyte per second at the headquarters site. The following slides will touch upon the features, options, and pricing elements required for Ethernet transport service. Some use cases for Ethernet transport service are provided here. An agency could use Ethernet transport services in a multipoint to multipoint configuration to interconnect LANs in the same city to form a MAN, or LANs in a different city and/or countries to form a WAN. Such configurations could give agency personnel transparent access to the organization's combined information throughout a city, the country, or the world. An agency could use ETS to replace a slower, more expensive data transport service, resulting in integrated voice and data transport, increased transmission bandwidth, improved performance, and a reduction in maintenance and operating costs. Ethernet Transport Service on the EIS contract provides agencies with the ability to meet their dynamic bandwidth demands without having to purchase or install new ports, which is costly and time-consuming. Scalable bandwidth enables an agency to plan for known periods of increased bandwidth needs. On EIS, there are several scalable bandwidth features that guarantee a committed bandwidth while ensuring the availability for increased capacity up to the maximum speed of the port. The scalable bandwidth capability, combined with the bandwidth on demand option available under EIS, provides agencies with the additional flexibility to order increased capacity for a period of time, during which increased demand is required. An example of a scalable bandwidth on demand scenario would be the IRS needing increased bandwidth during tax season. Burstable bandwidth is a capability that allows an agency to subscribe to a bandwidth commitment that is less than the full bandwidth of the selected Ethernet port, but allows for a burst to the full bandwidth of the selected port. The Ethernet burstable feature guarantees a committed bandwidth while ensuring the availability of the increased capacity. For each available Ethernet burstable feature, there is a corresponding auto-sold burstable overage usage CLIN that simplifies ordering. Bandwidth used in excess of the committed burstable bandwidth is invoiced via this overage usage CLIN. Burstable bandwidth is a viable option when an organization has unpredictable bandwidth spikes. For example, large periodic video conferences that require a bandwidth boost to accommodate the extra participants. In comparing scalable and burstable bandwidth options, the trade-off is whether to pay for bandwidth that you may never use, burstable, or to pay for the bandwidth as you need it and use it, scalable. The next couple of slides will provide additional details on the bandwidth on demand options and how they are linked to the scalable bandwidth committed rates. Per the provisioning SLA on the EIS contract, the bandwidth increases and decreases must be completed within 24 hours. Scalable is an option that allows an agency to establish a minimum and a maximum bandwidth. For example, on the low end, there is a 3 megabits per second committed scalable up to 10 megabits per second feature. And on the high end, there is a 3 gigabits per second committed scalable up to the 10 gigabits per second feature. And there are a number of other options in between. When an agency orders one of the scalable bandwidth features, they can also include the bandwidth on demand feature that allows for temporary bandwidth increases to be ordered. The usage charging unit is dependent upon the customer's existing committed bandwidth. It is 1 megabits per second per day for committed band rates up to 10 megabits per second. 10 megabits per day for committed rates up to 100 megabits per second. 100 megabits per second per day for committed rates up to 1 gigabit per second. And 1 gigabit per second per day for committed rates up to 10 gigabits per second. In addition, as shown in the notes column, the scalable bandwidth on-demand feature requires the use of a scalable ELAN Ethernet port. The burstable bandwidth capability allows agencies to subscribe to a bandwidth commitment that is less than the full bandwidth of the selected ETS port. The agency gets the committed bandwidth, and they may burst to the full bandwidth without placing an order or any interruption of service. On the low end, there is a 20 megabits per second committed burstable up to 100 megabits per second. And on the high end, there is a 600 megabits per second committed burstable up to 1 gigabit per second. And like the scalable feature, there are a number of options in between. If the agency exceeds the committed bandwidth, they will get an overage charge for the extra bandwidth used. This pricing model is similar to cell phone data plans. As shown on the slide, for each Ethernet burstable MRC CLIN, there is a corresponding burstable overage auto-sold usage CLIN to simplify ordering. The charging unit for burstable overage is 1 megabit per second for each of the committed data rates. For Ethernet transport service, there will be a monthly charge for the cost of each Ethernet port based on its speed and added capabilities. Added options will also affect pricing. On EIS, there are scalable and burstable options available that may be selected. For the scalable bandwidth on-demand options and the burstable option, there may be usage charges associated with any capacity overages. And based on the service option required, i.e. private E-line or private E-LAN, there may be other associated costs. For example, for the private E-line service, there is a charge for an Ethernet Virtual Connection, EVC, and for the private E-LAN service, with a bandwidth on-demand option, a scalable port is required. Access arrangement must be separately priced and purchased. It is not included with the service. All of this information is detailed in Section B and C of the EIS contract. As mentioned on the last slide, there are two dedicated services options available, Ethernet Private E-Line and Ethernet Private E-LAN. E-Line is a service providing point-to-point connectivity between two customer Ethernet ports over a WAN. Fixed bandwidth speeds from 1 megabit per second up to 40 gigabits per second over Ethernet virtual connections are available under EIS standard CLINs. Contractors may be able to deliver any customer requested speed, including 100 gigabits per second, under the contract using an individual case-based CLIN. The pricing structure for Ethernet Private E-Line is the port MRCs at each end of the connection, plus the EVC MRC required for the private E-Line, plus any available options, will equal the total charge. Ethernet Private E-LAN is a multi-point service connecting a set of customer endpoints, three or more, providing the agency's end users with a grouped Ethernet network by connecting all the sites. Ethernet fixed bandwidth speeds for E-LAN from 1 megabit per second up to 40 gigabits per second are available under EIS standard CLINs. Again, contractors can deliver any customer-requested speeds, including 100 gigabits per second, under the contract, using an ICB CLIN. The pricing structure for the private E-LAN Ethernet service is the port MRC charge for all locations connected, plus usage for the bandwidth on-demand options or burstable overage charges, plus any options, such as the expedited provisioning NRC, will equal the total charge for the service. Finally, as shown in the box at the top right, provisioning for this service is ICB and gets defined in the task order. There is no common standard provisioning SLA for this service. However, there is an E-LAN expedited provisioning CLIN, EN40001, that can be ordered. This provides for provisioning within 24 hours for the bandwidth on-demand options.